The first concept to understand in dynamics and chaos is iteration, that is, doing something again and again. For example, let's think about population growth. Population growth is an iterative process, since reproduction happens over and over again. We're going to be looking at an extremely simple model of population growth, called Simple Population Growth .nlogo. As usual, this is available on the course materials page of our website. Let's open it up. In this model, when we click Setup, it starts us off with a single individual making up our population. The birth rate is 2, which means that at every time step, this little bunny will produce 2 offspring and die. So if we click Reproduce, you can see that happening. There's the 2 offspring. Now at the next time step, each one of these bunnies produces 2 offspring and dies. And so on, and so on. And very quickly, the world starts to fill up with more and more of these bunnies. The model shows us 2 plots. The top one here gives us the population over time. So at every time step, the population is doubling. You can see that goes up quickly. It also gives us another plot, another way of looking at this, in which we plot last year's population with this year's population. If we think of a year as each time step represents a year. If last year's population is, say, 100, this year's population will be 200. You can see that here. And if it's 300 last year, it will be 600 this year. And so you can see we get a straight line. This couldn't be simpler, right? Well, because it's so simple, I'm going to show you how to turn this into a mathematical model. So let's close NetLogo here. Let's put this aside. And let's write down some equations. First, some terminology. Let's call the population n, little n. So this is the population. Now let's label the initial population n sub 0. In our model, n sub 0 was equal to 1. There was only one individual. So we can similarly label n sub 1 equals the population at year 1, and so on. For us, that was 2, because our initial 1 bunny had 2 bunnies and then died. And more generally, we can label the population at year t as n sub t. So whatever year you like. We also had a value for the birth rate, which was the number of offspring produced each year. We noticed that n sub 1 was equal to the birth rate times n sub 0, right? So we had 1 at the beginning, and we multiplied that by 2 to get 2 offspring. Similarly, n sub 2 equals the birth rate times n sub 1. We can generalize that to say that n sub t plus 1, that is the population at year t plus 1, is the birth rate times the population at the previous year, n sub t. So this is our model. The iterative part comes from the fact that we always take the last year's population and use it to calculate the next year's population. And then in the year after that, we would take this new population and use it to calculate the following year's population, and so on. And that's called an iteration. This is called exponential population growth. And we can see that as follows. Let's write down a table up here of the population growth. So we'll write down here the year, and here we'll write down n of t. So this is year t and n of t. So when we have year 0, we remember that this was 1, and this is for birth rate equals 2. At year one, we had two. At year two, we had four, because we're doubling these each year. At year three, we had eight, and so on. And I hope you're seeing a pattern here, because at year T, we see that our population is 2 raised to the t power. So 2 to the 1, 2 to the 2, 2 to the 3, 2 to the t. This is called an exponential function because we have this exponent, t, and that causes the population to grow very, very fast. Of course, this is completely unrealistic. It's uncontrolled population growth, and of course, in the real world, there are limits to growth. A population will run out of resources. They'll run out of food or space in which to grow. But we'll just, for now, we'll assume there's no limit to growth. And now let's look again at the NetLogo version of this model. So remember, here we have our world filling up with bunnies. And we had our plot of population versus time. But now we can plot this year's population versus last year's population. Now this one here, population versus time, is an exponential function. That was that function that had the 2 raised to the t power in it. That's what an exponential function looks like. But if we plot this year's population versus last year's population, we get a linear function. And we can put a little note on it to remind ourselves what the function was, and that's the function n, lowercase n, sub t plus 1 equals the birth rate times n sub t. For those of you who vaguely remember algebra, algebra 1 even, this is the equation of a line. We have y equals slope times x. So here's our y-axis. Our slope is the birth rate, that's 2. This just shows that every time we look at x, we double it to get y. Well, this is a linear equation, and the reason it's linear is because this is, in essence, a linear system if we look at this year's population versus last year's population. Now, we've talked in Unit 1 about the notion of nonlinear versus linear. Linear comes about because there's no interactions among these bunnies. You just have reproduction, and the bunnies are going along all independent of each other. And independence, in that sense, in a system, yields linearity, linear growth. Okay, now it's time for a quiz. Now suppose the birth rate goes up to 3. We'll let the initial population, N0, be one bunny again. The question is, what is the population at time 4?